Hi, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to review Aveeno. I have Aveeno Daily Moisturizing Lotion and I have the Dermixer Emollient Cream. I have been using this thing for a long time, but this is something I have started using recently and I like it. Anyway, let's start this video with one thing. There are like three kinds of ingredients. First, emollient. What emollient does? It moisturizes our skin. Then we have occlusive. What occlusive does? It protects our skin and it can block the water loss. Then we have humectants. What humectant does? Can attract water to the skin. So these two creams, they have all these three things. Most of the creams, they have these ingredients like occlusive, emollient and humectant. What I like about these two products that they are fragrance free and they have very short ingredients list, and these are like designed for sensitive skin. But one thing I can tell you for the sure, that this one is non-comedogenic, but about this one I'm not certain. So let's start with this Dermixer cream. It is for dry, actually for extra dry skin. It claims to provide relief against roughness, redness, itching, tightness and scaling. The brand claims that it is formulated to minimize the risk of allergies and it is for eczema prone skin. This cream is kind of thick and fragrance free. This daily moisturizing lotion is fragrance free as well. This is less thick than the Dermixer cream. You can see the comparison side by side. But these creams, actually they don't feel greasy at all. This is non-sticky, but it has this feeling that it's sitting on the top of our skin. These are mostly used for the body, and this Dermixer cream, it has pretty good ingredients. And first ingredients are water, glycerin, humectant, panthenol. It can very well soothe our skin. Then it has this sterol, demonium chloride. It can moisturize our skin, and this ingredient actually used in hair conditioners as well. Even this daily moisturizer cream has the same ingredients, glycerin, but it doesn't have panthenol. And then it has petrolatum. So we have this misconceptions about petrolatum because we think it is bad for our skin, mainly because there is this rumor that it is connected to cancer, something like that. See, there is this industry grade petrolatum products which can be problematic, but cosmetic grade petrolatum ingredients, they are highly refined, so they don't have those bad ingredients, so it is generally safe. And Lia Wu, she has this wonderful video about this petrolatum and silicones, urea and parabens, because there are these myths about these ingredients. So I'm going to leave the link of that video in the description box and you will find this very helpful. Please watch the video. She has explained about these ingredients in a very good way, and even Dr. Dre, she had spoken about silicones, parabens, and you can watch her videos to get more information if these ingredients can be good for our skin and can actually work. So why would we exclude these ingredients? For some ingredients that don't have enough proofs or evidences like scientific backup, please watch those videos and read few articles, like good articles. Washington Post, they have one article on this thing. I'm gonna leave the link down below. So if you want to talk about it, we can talk about it in the comment box, because I highly appreciate your views and opinions. Then this Dermixer cream has this isopropyl permeate, and even this daily moisturizing lotion, it has this ingredient. And there is this one issue about this ingredient, because if this ingredient is not diluted well, then it can cause acne, it can be comedogenic. So here they have used this as sixth ingredient, and even here I think it is the sixth ingredient. Yeah, so I don't know why they have leveled this as non-comedogenic, but this is, I couldn't find the level for this. And this can be a trigger for acne prone skin if it is not formulated enough. But I have used this on my face. See, all skin types, they can use this on their hands, like hand cream, or on their neck, on their body. But when it comes to face, it can be problematic for some, because these creams can feel a little heavy. And I'm gonna show you the texture. It actually sits on the skin, I think, because this is a Dermixer cream, but it doesn't feel greasy. This is not sticky, but I definitely can feel something is there on my skin. And many of us, they don't like this feeling. But actually what happens, it is preventing the water loss by creating this moisture barrier. This is a Dermixer cream and this is their daily moisturizing lotion. And this daily moisturizing lotion is actually for normal to dry skin, and it is leveled as non-comedogenic. Look, we don't need to use much of these creams. I'm using way too much hair because I want you to see the texture and the feel precisely. If I apply it too much, it peels off. And we really don't need much. See, I'm not using this cream now on my face. It has this one ingredient, that is benzyl alcohol. It can work as preservative and it is okay when it's used in low concentration. This is the second last ingredient, benzyl alcohol. Then it has sodium chloride, which is salt. But I'm not comfortable with this ingredient. This one, Dermexa cream, doesn't have this benzyl alcohol. So I'm using this. One more thing, benzyl alcohol, it can be good when it's used in low quantity. It is only problematic when it's used in like high concentration. So it should be good, but I have this prejudice against this ingredient. So I don't like this in my skincare. So I avoid that. So it's my issue. Dermexa has ceramide as well, but daily moisturizing lotion doesn't have ceramide. This Dermexa cream has oat extract, oat oil and oat flour. And this cream just has oat flour. These both creams, they have silicones. If you don't like silicones in your skincare, then it's not gonna be good for you. You are either gonna hate this cream on your face or you're gonna love it. There's no in between. And for the people who have oily skin, I don't think it's gonna be a very good idea for you during the summer, maybe during the winter time. And I use this just twice in a week. I have slightly dry and sensitive skin. I use this one at night twice in a week. I use the serum, then I put the emulsion, then I put this cream on and I add 2 drops of squalane. That's my skincare routine and it never broke me out, neither this one. But since it has this benzyl alcohol, I'm not comfortable using this anymore. But benzyl alcohol, it can be safe when it's used in low quantity, but it is just me, I don't want to use it. Because I had the better option and it has better ingredients any day. It has ceramides, 3 types of oats and panthenol. So this one is the best, but this is lighter. It is slightly thicker than this one and we need really little quantity of it. People who like this light cream, very lightweight moisturizers, they won't like this cream because it sits on the skin. You will feel something is there, you know. It's not like, you know, nothing is there kind of feeling, like very light textured like gel moisturizers. It is not that. It actually feels very good on the skin, but this is not for everyone. If it suits you, it's gonna be very great. If it doesn't suit you, then it's gonna be an issue. But everyone can use this as hand creams or neck creams because these days we're using so much sanitizers, so our hands are getting dry. And these creams can be actually pretty good option because these are fragrance free and it's very difficult to find one hand cream or any moisturizer that is fragrance free, and this is a real struggle. And this have pretty good ingredients in it. And for our facial skin, if it suits you, then it's gonna be very great. And if it doesn't, then what to do? Skincare is very subjective. So that's all for now. I hope you found this video to be helpful and thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you want to watch more videos like this. See you very soon. Bye bye.